final game of the day here at the 2020 Nova Scotia Under 18 Major Hockey League Showcase Weekend. The final game features Sydney Mitsubishi Rush, who played earlier today and lost a heartbreaker 4-3 to the Halifax McDonald's, against the South Shore Mustangs, who are playing their one and only game of the showcase here this weekend. The reason being, quite simply, games got postponed thanks to the COVID-19 virus. The South Shore Mustangs were scheduled to play yesterday against the Halifax McDonald's. That game got postponed. I do not believe that postponement was COVID-related. I have not seen any word as to the reason for that postponement. The Mustangs were scheduled to play earlier today against the against the Cole Harbour Pro Hockey Life Wolfpack. That game was postponed because of COVID, as the Cole Harbour team was not able to travel due to a COVID situation in the Cole Harbour area. Whether that situation specifically includes a player or a member of the personnel of the Cole Harbour Wolfpack, we do not know, and to make any sort of speculation would be irresponsible. All we know is it was a COVID-related cancellation. Not saying that there was a person who is a part of the staff or a part of the team who is as tested positive. Whether it was a close contact, who's to say? All we know is that games were postponed. For the Rush, they were scheduled to play against Cole Harbour yesterday. That game, again, postponed because the Wolfpack not able to make the trip up. So, the Mustangs, they had their Halifax game postponed, they had their Cole Harbour game postponed, so this is the only game that they are playing here at the Dictionary Wellness Center this weekend. For the Mitsubishi Rush, they had a game earlier today. They ended up dropping that one 4-3 to the all day. So certainly this will be a significant challenge for the Sydney Mitsubishi Rush, who come into this game sitting in sixth place in the Nova Scotia Under 18 Major Hockey League standings. For the Mustangs though, they have had their struggles all season long. Their record just 2-6. They have the league's lowest producing offense, under 3 goals a game. They have the most porous defense right now, giving up more than 5 goals a game. The Wildcats are just under them. The Wildcats are at 5 goals exactly per game. The Mustangs are at 5.13 goals against per game. So they have the lowest standing defense, the lowest standing offense, and the league's worst overall goal differential. Both the Mustangs and the Wildcats are at -18, but the Mustangs have done that in just 8 games, so their goal differential is -2.25 per game, whereas the Wildcats, that means in 18 is over 11 games, so they're at -1.64. So for the Rush, this could be a chance to have that bounce-back performance that they need after that heartbreaking loss. For the Mustangs, this could be a team ahead of them in the standings who fight for the pickings. We'll find out over the next couple of hours. We should mention very quickly the rest of the scores throughout this event. It was set up in a way as two separate pools. You had the Wheat, the host team, playing games against Dartmouth Steel Subaru, against the Voltec Valley Wildcats, and against the Cape Breton West Islanders. That part of the tournament, although it's not technically a tournament, the Weeks ended with a record of 1-2, dropping a 4-2 decision to Dartmouth Steel Subaru, dropping a 4-3 decision to Cape Breton West Islanders, and earning a 5-0 victory over, a 5-1 victory, over the Valley Wildcats. Valley finished with a record of 1-2 as well. They started with a victory over the Cape Breton West Islanders by a score of 4-3, and then they dropped both of today's games. A wild one against Dartmouth this morning, 8-6, and then that 5-1 loss against the Weeks in their third and final game. For Steel Subaru, they right now have a record of 2-0. They beat the Weeks 4-2 yesterday. They beat Valley 8-6 earlier today, and right now they are leading 3-1 with 12 seconds, or no, that's a timeout, excuse me. They're leading 3-1 late in the third period. Trying to see how much time is left exactly, as someone has just called the timeout. There's 2:11 left to go in that game. Steel Subaru leading that game right now 3-1 over the Cape Breton West Islanders. So if they can win that, they will finish the weekend 3-0. The Islanders, like the Weeks and Valley, would finish 1-2. The Islanders, as mentioned, lost on the opening day to the Valley Wildcats 4-3. They beat the Weeks 4-3 earlier today and are trailing right now 3-1 with just a couple of minutes left in regulation. Once that game becomes a final, we'll let you know. The other pool, as it were, the pool that involves the teams who are playing tonight, the Mustangs and the Rush, with the 3 games involving Cole Harbour getting postponed, that left just 3 of the 6 games that were originally scheduled. Halifax and South Shore didn't play their game, so that one has to be rescheduled. So we only had 2 games out of this pool, one being the Rush game earlier today that we mentioned, where they lost 4-3 to the Mavs, and this one that's scheduled to start in roughly 4 minutes from now. So that takes you through all of the results of today and yesterday here at the 2020 Showcase Weekend. Taking a look now at today's starting goaltenders. Starting for the Mustangs is going to be Cooper Fleming. Cooper Fleming gets the start. Comes in with a record of 1-3, a 4.75 goals against average, and an .872 save percentage. For the Rush, it's going to be Andrew Burke getting the start. He has a record of 1-4, a 6.33 goals against average, and a .772 save percentage. They're into the final minute next door, and I see that Cape Breton West has scored a goal to pull the within one. And they're in for a wild finish. door there. I have no idea if you can even hear me right now, but I'm going to keep trying to do my job. As absurd as it sounds, as we get set up for today's game between the South Shore Mustangs and the Sydney Mitsubishi Rush. The Rush will be the home team for this game. They're in their white jerseys. The Mustangs are the visiting team. They will be in their blue jerseys with the red numbers. Still waiting for the referees to be fair bids as well.
That I'm even seeing.
Wellness Center. Mustangs and Rush. Mustangs with a record of 3-6, sixth in the league. Rush with a record of 2-6, tied for seventh. Played out towards the front of the net, comes all the way to the line. Alfred with the shot. That's fanned on, and then a chance for McCarty. And it gets deflected up over the glass now to play, and we're going to stop it with 19 seconds gone here in the first period. I should point out, because I don't have a direct mic, the audio quality is going to be not where it should be. There's a dangerous hit delivered by McCarty as Pattengill gets taken into the boards awkwardly. And they're going to call that cross-checking. Could just as easily have been a very, very short night for McCarty. As the Mustangs will go to the penalty kill, just 24 seconds in. Power play of the Rush gets to go to work here in the early going. And we can tell you that in the game earlier today, there were a lot of penalties called, but I'm thinking of the wrong game. In the game between the Rush and the Mats earlier today, the Rush had just two power play opportunities. They did not score on either of them, or they scored on one of them, excuse me. Games are starting to blend together as this is the sixth game in 2 days that I'm calling here. Played back to the line here. Sala with it along. Takes a shot that goes off the stick of Zwicker. Hawk comes back to Sala. Sala with it again. Now to O'Neill. O'Neill right down to the side of the net. Now O'Neill in front. McIntyre couldn't get a shot away. Puck comes back to the line. O'Neill. His shot, that gets blocked, and the puck out to center. Sala picks up there. They'll bring it right back in again. Sala trying to center it to O'Neill. That goes off of Zwicker. He takes it to the wall and then to the line, not out, held in by Marr. Marr has that taken off of his stick. And it comes to Marr, he takes a shot. My fans on it. Sala with the shot, that goes wide. Now Sala with it again. His shot or his pass gets deflected away, and coming across to make the save, Cooper Fleming, and he'll hang on for a face-off. 25 seconds left in the penalty. Face-off to the right of the Mustang goaltender. Neither side really wins the draw cleanly. Eventually it's down in towards the corner. Allen plays it back to the line to Pattengill. Pattengill to Baldwin. Back to Pattengill. Pattengill again to Baldwin. Baldwin now comes near side to Christmas. Christmas with a shot. And there's too much traffic in front. Penalty about to come to an end. Allen in behind the net. Allen goes to play it back to Baldwin. That misses him and goes down the length of the ice. And the faceoff will come to center ice as an icing call was made in error. And once again, hey, these officials, they're human beings. Mistakes happen, no big deal. Faceoff in neutral ice and everything's all good. Off of the draw. Body able to bring it into the Rush zone. Now it comes to the near side. Hawkins with a shot. Traffic in front. Puck ends up coming back to Hawkins. He'll play it off of the boards and into the... comes off the boards there for McNeil. McNeil not able to do an awful lot with that as there's three Rush players all right around him. Now McKenzie wraps it around the far side and held in at the line. Clark misses with his check. The puck comes to Hopkins, his shot comes off the end boards. It'll be picked up there by Matthews. He's able to get it out and down the length of the ice. That will be an icing, and this time it is called correctly with 3:14. gone here in period number one. Draw one back to the line, Asbridge. As something fell on the ice there. I think it's somebody's net part. Puck goes down into the corner, in behind the net. Baldwin, he'll wrap it around the board. Held in by Asbridge. Now comes to the line. Ritzy plays it towards the net. And Baldwin gets it back again. Comes back to the line again for Asbridge. He'll send it down into the near side corner. Picked up there by Sampson. Sampson fires it down the ice, and that's going to be another icing call against the Rush. With 3:52 gone. And now we find out that it was indeed the neck guard of Landon Clark. Draw one right back to Connors this time. His shot gets veered towards the near side corner. Comes back to the line. Held in there by Downton Hayes. Or Downton Haynes, excuse me. And finally the Rocks are able to come out. Sampson gains the red line. He'll dump it down. And the Sydney Mitsubishi Rush make wholesale changes. That gives the Mustangs a chance to come back up the ice, but they end up misplaying that. And it goes for an icing call with 4:22 gone here in the first period. Still no score between the Rush and the Mustangs. It's the final game of the 2020 Nova Scotia Under 18 Major Hockey League Showcase Weekend. Here's Wicker. He'll play it ahead. For Leon Wand, it gets a little bit beyond him, down into the corner. Christmas going in after it. Christmas in there, working against Leon Wand. Also in there was LaFrenz. Now, pass ahead for McIntyre. McIntyre gains the red line, dumps it in. Fleming comes out of his net and settles it there for Hawkins. Hawkins plays it up the near wall. LaFrenz pinching in from the point. Able to work it back down towards the corner. Now it'll be taken by Westlake. He goes behind the net. Turns and comes back towards the near side. Passed ahead for Cook. Cook has that roll away from him. LaFrenz sends it back the other way. Hopkins dumps it in right onto the goaltender, Burke. Now, down towards the corner. Berkovici trying to center it. Puck comes back to the line. Hopkins back to Berkovici at the near wall. Berkovici, and if I'm mispronouncing a name, please let me know. My Twitter handle, at PetterPC_sports. That's Petter, PetterPC, as in Pictou County, _ sports, as in what you're watching. And let me know the correct pronunciation of any names that I might be getting wrong. Pattendale, there's a couple of chances, and Fleming just able to keep that one out. As the Rush gets some opportunities there. By Cooper Fleming, able to stand tall and keep this game scoreless here in the early going. As the Mustangs take on the Rush here, 6 minutes gone or just about here in the first period. Battle in the corner. Referee yelling at them to move it. Finally, it does come loose to Wilkin. Wilkin, his pass for Potty. Potty able to play it to McNeil. McNeil had trouble holding it. It ended up going back to Potty, but in that little quick little switch up, it ended up putting the Mustangs into an offside position with 6:12 gone here in period number one. Quick reminder, Petter Pictou Sports, the home of all week's majors home games. We've already seen the Rush here a couple of times. We've seen the Mustangs here once through the regular season so far. So anytime either of these two teams or any team is coming into the Pictou County Wellness Center to take on the Weeks, you know you can catch that game right here on Petter Pictou Sports through 360 Live. O'Neill plays it back to the line. Pattengill, he takes a shot, steered aside. And another chance and another save made by Cooper Fleming. Cooper Fleming coming up big here in the early going. Coming in to take the draw is Brennan Coleman. He'll take it against Marr. Coleman wins it down towards the corner, and then Harlow wraps it around to the near side wall. Puck comes to Marr. He fires a shot that goes wide all the way up the wall to Pattingale. Now back to Marr. He has it knocked away from him. Joseph not able to clear the zone. Here comes Pattingale in again. Towards the front. There's Marr. He scores! Nick Marr able to take that pass in his hand, drop it down to his stick, and then put it into the net, and the Rush take the first goal of the game and go ahead 1-0 for Marr. He scored once early in the game earlier today. So for Marr, that's his 11th goal, 15 points of the season. As we await announcement to confirm, Pattingale should get one assist. Wait to find out if there is a second one. And the exact time will blow right around the 7-minute mark. So 7:07 the time of the ball. They announced it as Crane, and that should have been Pattingale and Seymour. Shot fired, they score! Blast from the point by Cohen, Brown, and Haynes, and just like that, it's 1-1. So the Rush held the lead for a minute and 2 seconds. So Cohen from Cohen at 8:09 to tie up this game with a goal apiece. Knocked down deep into the Rush zone, picked up behind the net there, taken by Campbell. Campbell to McIntyre. McIntyre flips it out to center and sent right back into the Rush zone again. And Campbell picks up yet again, plays it ahead for Edwards. Edwards loses the puck. Cook. Now Berkovici, it ends up back with Edwards, but in an offside position was Crane, and so we'll get a stoppage with 10:39 left to go here in the first, and the score tied up at a goal apiece. Edwards ends up winning it all the way back deep into his own zone. Pattingale back to pick up. He'll play it around for Soller. That pass just a little bit off target. Cook sends it back behind the net. Berkovici, he'll play it around into the far corner. But then it's turned over and sent out to center. Astrid plays it back in. Pattingale gives to Soller. Soller looks like he's going to go one way, then goes the other. Across to Pattingale. His pass a little bit behind Edwards. And then it's sent right back down into the rush zone yet again. Pattingale just avoids the forecheck of Perkovici. Played ahead there for Allen. Allen sets it up for Edwards. Edwards overskates the puck as it was knocked off of his stick. And in and out of the zone a couple of times. Now it's picked up by Soller. Here's Soller. He steps into Wilson as he gets the puck into the zone. Allen down into the corner. As they battle for it there, it's going to be Hopkins who gets to it. He's met immediately by Hutchings. But the Mustangs able to stay on the puck. Wilkin gets it ahead. He made the pass through to McDonald, but McDonald couldn't get a shot away as he was tied up. Now they battle in the corner for it. Just under 11 minutes gone. Here's a chance in front! And what a save by Andrew Burke! As all alone in front with a glorious opportunity was, I believe that Elijah Lane won. Actually, it was McNeil, Brock McNeil, 18, not 19. My apologies. The thick font sometimes makes the eights and the nines look similar. As they battle along the wall there, just inside the blue line. Referee telling him to move it, move it, move it. Finally, the puck still tied up. Finally, the referee says enough's enough. And the faceoff will come outside because it was tied up there by a Mustang player. 8:45 left to go in the first period. Tied up at a goal apiece. Ross took the lead, the goal by Nick Marr, his second goal of the day after he scored in the game this morning against the Halifax McDonalds, or earlier this afternoon, excuse me, against the Halifax McDonalds. But the lead lasted only a minute and 2 seconds as South Shore responded with Cohen Dowden-Hayes, his first goal with the Mustangs this season in just his third game as a member of the Mustangs. Here comes O'Neill. O'Neill gets around one man, makes the pass across, and the goal for Riley Seymour. Nick Marr could have gotten his stick on it, but he let it go to Seymour instead. And Seymour gets that one in. It's now 2-1. 11:32, the time of the goal. For Ryan Seymour, that's his fourth goal, ninth point of the season, second point of this game after he had an assist on the first goal. And as we wait for the official word, all of my passes directed are the assists. So again, it's Riley Seymour's fourth goal, fifth point, assisted by Logan O'Neill and Drew Baldwin at 11:32 to make it once again a must lead. Now 2-1. Potty goes to play it ahead. That goes off of Clark. And then Potty gets a bump. Now Clark fans on a shot attempt and the puck rolls into the far corner. Wrapped around to the near side, picking up and coming out with it is Harlow. Harlow still on the puck. Harlow still on the puck, takes the shot. And the save made by Burke, and he'll hang on for a faceoff. 7:02 left to go here in the period. And the Rush leading it 2-1. for a team that's had to play a whole other game today against a team that's looking, that is well rested. The Rush certainly not looking behind a step, although it is still the first period. That is something we'll definitely have to watch for as the game moves on. Wilkin having trouble getting that puck settled down. It ends up with Pattingale. He'll dump it in. Comes all the way around the boards to the near side. Now, the Mustangs able to play it out. Trying to get there in time is Luke McDonald. He doesn't, so it's going to be an icing call against the Mustangs. With 6:29 left to go here in the first period. Edwards in to take the draw. It's won by McNeil, but now Edwards gets the puck, although he's tied up with the official. Tried to play it down to Allen. Allen tied up by Asbridge. Coming in to help out is Hutchings. Hutchings gets it to Edwards. Edwards plays it back to Pattingale. And now the Mustangs able to get it out, but Pattingale gets the stick on that puck to deny the rush. Here comes Pattingale. Pattingale still with it. Tried to make a pass across. That gets broken up. And the Mustangs able to play it out to center. Edwards picks up just on the Crusher logo. Plays it over to Soller. Dan Soller being hassled there by Ritzy. Still with the puck though, able to get it ahead for Allen. He loses it to Hopkins, but Soller following up on the play. Here comes Dan Soller. Has it knocked away from him. Now Hopkins will get it out. And picking up is Joseph. Joseph sends it deep into the rush zone. Joseph takes a hit there in the end boards from Soller. Under 5.5 to go here, first period. Played back to the line. Shot from the point. Save made by Burke. And now the Mustangs get possession again. Sent towards the corner. Edwards will get onto it first, though. As not able to get there in time was Ritzy. Now it's played up the wall. Off the wall by Allen, but not hard enough to get it out of the zone. Rush will have another opportunity to clear, and this time they will do so as McIntyre gets it out to O'Neill. Soller got it to O'Neill. And now dumped down the ice by Reese Allen. Zwicker plays it ahead. Mustang was dumping in near side corner, going in after it there and getting there in a hurry was Westlake. He tried to send that, but that's broken up. Mara coming the other way. Now feeds it over to Seymour. Seymour coming in. Seymour! And he just has that puck roll off the stick as he was able to get around the goaltender Fleming, but couldn't maintain control of that puck. Baldwin now near side. Gets to Mara. Mara with the shot. And Fleming with the save. O'Neill takes it behind the net. Comes into the near corner. Puck bouncing around. O'Neill gets it back again. Trying to work it back down the boards, but it's taken out by Zwicker. Back on it is McKenzie. He'll play it ahead for Marr. Marr across the blue line. Marr with the shot. That goes into the end glass. Coming over to pick up was Ritchie, but it's knocked down. And now up comes Berkovici. Berkovici coming in. Berkovici tried to get a pass through to Cook, but Cook wasn't expecting it, was looking the wrong way, and it ended up going through his feet. Played ahead, all the way into the rush zone, backing up with it, McKenzie. He'll play it across. Takes a bump, or takes a deflection. Asbridge sending it back in. McKenzie there. He plays it up the wall. Picked up now by Matthews. He ends up losing it to Berkovici. Berkovici plays it through the crease, and it rolls harmlessly to Cook. Now Baldwin tries to get it over Cook. Cook able to hold, knock it down, and then gives it to McCarty. Excuse me. Now Asbridge. McCarty slightly overskates the puck. Here's Berkovici with it. He'll come down into the corner. Berkovici still on it, now gives to McCarty. Here's Wilkin with a shot, that gets blocked. And Clark able to play it off the boards and down the ice. Hustling back to get on it is Wilkin. Wilkin turns it quickly ahead down the ice. Hustling back to get on it is LaFrenz. LaFrenz stops behind the net, reverses direction. Clearing pass, knocked down by McNeil. McNeil with a shot. That goes off the end boards. Hopkins now, his shot. And a kick save made by Burke. LaFrenz plays it to Campbell. Campbell able to get it ahead. And the puck flips softly out and down the ice. Hustling back is Harlow. Harlow loses control. There's a shot, save, rebound! And what a save by Cooper Fleming! A wide open net for Drew McKenzie. It took him an extra second to settle the puck down, and that was all the time that Cooper Fleming needed to make a diving save coming across with 1:52 left to go in the first period. An amazing save by Cooper Fleming. Puck played through the line and it gets just out. Pattingale sends it back in. Now the Mustangs will work their way out again. Puck comes to Ritzy. He goes to play it ahead. It goes off of Coleman. Now way up high in the air and it'll come down for Dowden Haynes. Coleman able to get it down into the rush zone. First one on it is Soller. He plays it to Pattingale, who's able to get it ahead. And getting it the rest of the way out was Crane. In neutral ice, picked up by Ritzy. Ritzy able to get it through. Here comes a chance for Coleman. Coleman coming in! And able to stay with him long enough was Burke as he outrun the final minute of period number one. Here comes a shot taken by Connors and the save made by Burke, and he'll hang on to it and get a stoppage with 51.2 seconds left to go in the first period. Draw one by the Mustangs, Westlake. Now comes to the front of the net, trying to turn and get a shot away there was Wilkin. That was Zwicker, and then Wilkin took the shot from the point. Now Hasbridge plays it back into the rush zone. Baldwin, trying to spring Edwards. That gets broken up. Now Allen will back the puck up. McKenzie has to go all the way back behind his own net. 22 seconds left in the period. Pass up for Edwards. Edwards has it knocked off his stick by Westlake. Now played out to center. Wilkin there waiting for it. He'll dump it back in. It goes just off to the side of the net. McKenzie plays it to the near side for Baldwin as they're trying to kill the last couple seconds. Played out. Here's Allen. He'll dump it in. And that will do it for period number one. The Mustangs, or the Rush, took an early lead at 7:07 with the goal from Nick Marr. South Shore responded with Cohen Dowden Haynes getting his first goal a minute and 2 seconds later. And then at 11:32, it was Riley Seymour scoring to give the Rush the lead back again, 2-1, and that's where we stand after the opening 20 minutes. We'll take a break, come back, get ready for the second period in just a few minutes. You are watching the Nova Scotia Under-18 Major Hockey League Showcase Weekend from Petter Pictou Sports here on 360 Live. All right, welcome back as we get ready for the start of the second period here. The Rush leading the Mustangs by a score of 2-1. Taking a quick look at what else is going on around the area in the world of hockey. We'll start with the Nova Scotia Under 15 Major League. And the teams that represent these particular regions, South Shore winning today by a score of 5-3 over the Novas. The Jarlton Cougars, they were here in Pictou County over at the Hector Arena in the town of Pictou, losing to the Wirral Bombers by a score of 5-4. Elsewhere, the Rangers beat the King's Mutual Valley Wildcats 3-1. It was Pearl over Dartmouth by a score of 3-2. Halifax defeating Pro Hockey Life Harbor Storm by a score of 7-2. And it was the Gulls over the Bedford Blue Battalion Barons by a score of 2-1. Two finals so far in the Maritime Major Female Hockey League. We had an 8-1 victory for the Northern Subway Selects as they played a home game over in Antigonish. They were able to defeat the Bussies Auto Workers Penguins by that score of 8-1. Meanwhile, up in Cape Breton, it was a 5-2 victory for the Station 6 Fire over the Cape Breton Lynx. In the Nova Scotia Junior Hockey League, we take a look there. One game in progress right now. Valley is taking on the Brookfield Elks. One game that was scheduled for today had to be postponed. The Cumberland County Blues were supposed to take on the Junior Miners up in Membertou. That game had to be postponed due to the fact that the Blues, being in Spring Hill, several of their players live over in New Brunswick and were not able to make the trip into Nova Scotia. One game later tonight, East Hands at Liverpool. A couple of games from yesterday in the Nova Scotia Junior League, Liverpool beat East Hands 3-1. Valley beat Cole Harbour 7-6 in a shootout. And taking a look at the Maritime Hockey League today. Everything is a little later tonight in the Maritime is underway in the Maritime Hockey League rather. Miramichi beats Hamilton 1-0 going into the second period. No score going into the second period in Summerside, while the South Shore Lumberjacks are there taking on the Western Capitals. Yarmouth visiting the Valley, that game just ending the first period. And those are the three games on the schedule in the Maritime Hockey League here tonight. Meanwhile here, the Sydney Mitsubishi Rush with a 2-1 lead over the South Shore Mustangs. The Rush are the home team in this game, although of course both of these teams from a little further afield than here within Pictou County. Want to again extend thanks to High Button Sports for coming up to Pictou County this weekend and helping out with the games over on the other sheet of ice today. We really do appreciate having you here, helping us out with those broadcasts. By myself, I certainly couldn't run two rings at once. Both teams out ready to go, wanting to get this second period started, but the officials waiting out the full. Now they're going to get things going. They're going to say, let's get going. Let's get this second period underway. And here we are, the ball won by the Rush. Nightingale gets it ahead to Matthews. Now it's picked up by Wilkin. Wilkin will bring it in. Sends it towards the net. Pattingale quickly turning it up the other way. Ashbridge will go back, as does Body. Body plays it up the wall. Out the center. Here comes Wilkin with it. Wilkin gets tangled up with Pattingale. Luke McDonald able to pick up the puck. He gets it back to Wilkin. And now a pass intended for Matthews, broken up by Asbridge. He'll dump it in and peel off for a change while it's picked up there by Soller. Here comes Soller, working his way ahead. Sending the puck down the length of the ice. Picked up by the Mustangs and quickly working up. Now dumped into the near side corner. Wrapped around by McKenzie to Baldwin. He gets it up and trying to work his way free was O'Neill, but couldn't get the puck past the defense of the Mustangs. But as the Mustangs tried to work back into the zone, the play ends up going offside with 1:08 gone here in period number one. Marr in to take the draw there against Berkovici. Berkovici wins it back to Hopkins. Now there's a chance off of the post as what looked like a relatively innocent looking play. Getting just a piece of that puck was Cooper Fleming, and it ends up going off the outside of the post. Now here comes O'Neill right back in again. Logan O'Neill has it knocked off his stick by Berkovici. Berkovici works it up. McHenry can't get around McKenzie. Or McCarty, excuse me, couldn't get around McKenzie. O'Neill plays it back down the boards. Attempt at a centering pass, goes off the skate. O'Neill going after it at the far corner. Sends it behind the net. Hopkins will, or Berkovici will get there just ahead of Marr. Plays it around to McCarty. McCarty gets the puck as far as McKenzie. Then McKenzie tries to turn it back the other way. Battle along the near side wall. Coming out, Marr, he tried to feed it back to Seymour. That doesn't connect. It's played around to the far side. Marr will pick up there. Nick Marr gets taken into the boards there by Harlow. Mustangs come out with the puck, and here they come through center. Hopkins drops it off. Attempt to have a shot from McCarty, but he couldn't pull the trigger. Now coming the other way, here's a chance for... McIntyre. The puck ends up rolling in onto Cooper Fleming, and he'll cover up and hang on for a faceoff. 2:36 gone here in the third or second period. Anybody who's watching this game from the Pictou County area, if you're interested in joining Petter Pictou Sports, I am looking for someone to take over the camera duties because, as is quite obvious, and I'm trying to do camera and play-by-play and everything else, some things get missed, like, you know, remembering to change what period we're in. So contact me through Facebook, through Twitter, and let me know you're interested in working the camera for Petter Pictou Sports. There's a shot from Leon Wand. It goes up into the air and then falls down in the area behind the net. Now LaFrenz, he'll wrap it back around the wall. Gowden Haynes, he'll send it once again around to the near side. Off the wall, Connors holds it in, he fires the shot, that goes wide. Comes off the end boards, Wayne Warren over to pick up, he'll try and tie it up. Puck comes loose to Christmas, he plays it back, now up the wall. Gowden Haynes sends it back in, near side corner. Battles along the wall continues. That seems to be the theme of this shift. Now cutting to the middle of the ice. There's a chance for Coleman. And a big save made by Burke. Now looking out the center. Gavin Haynes just able to stay away from McIntyre. But Christmas able to get on the puck and bring it down to the corner. Up the wall. Picked up by Crane. He ends up overskating it. Christmas gets it back. Can't get a shot away, and now the Mustangs will come out. Coleman plays it across to Joseph. Joseph trying to get it back to Coleman. Doesn't quite connect. Now Coleman gets it back behind the net. Coleman works it up the wall, pinching in from the point, taking the shot, and that gets steered aside. That shot taken off the stick of, that was Wilkin. Now, sorry. Lost sight of the play there for a minute. I was looking at it, but didn't realize that my hand didn't quite follow. Puck picked up by LaFrenz. They'll play it to Soller. Van Soller now trying to work his way ahead, using the boards to get a pass up to himself. Gets past Asbridge. Now Soller looking to get it to McIntyre, and that goes just through McIntyre into the corner. Now a very awkward fall taken by Pattingale. That gives the Mustangs a chance to get back down, to get down the ice. Puck tied up in the corner, along the boards there. Trying to come in and help work it free as McDonald. Finally, the referee says, okay, enough's enough. We'll call it dead. With 5:21 gone here in the third period, or second period. Plays it down there, it's back to the line. Harlow back to Hopkins again. His shot through the traffic gets deflected, comes into the near corner. Crane takes a big hit there. Gets the puck as far as Edwards. Edwards gets it out. Harlow dumps it right back in again. Pattingale plays it across to Soller for Allen. Allen loses it as Berkovici got a stick on the puck. Near side, Pattingale tried to play it up to Allen. Allen gets it past Harlow. Hopkins hustles back to pick up that puck and sends it back up the other way. Berkovici can't reach that pass. It's picked up by Edwards. Here comes Edwards. Edwards drops off to Hutchins. Hutchins with the shot. And the save made by Fleming, and he'll hang on for a faceoff. Up the wall, McKenzie sends it back down around. Gowden Haynes plays it towards Zwicker. Zwicker couldn't get it under control. Now another chance to get it towards Zwicker, but it goes all the way to Baldwin. Baldwin's shot goes off the stick of Zwicker and into the near side wall. Matthews sends it down to the corner. Now Clark will set it up for Sampson behind the net. Sampson gets tangled up with Connors. Connors comes out with the puck. Sampson can't find it in his feet, finally does, and then it's off a stick and into the near side wall. Back to the line, McKenzie, and out to center, it had gone, and then it was sent back in, so that's going to be an offside against the Rush. Just under 7 minutes gone here in the second period. Into the Mustang end. Behind the net, played around in the near side. Campbell, not able to hold it, but O'Neill gets on the puck. He couldn't keep it in. Now Campbell. This pass a little bit too far in front of Seymour. Puck ends up coming on to Fleming anyway. McNeil working his way ahead, drops off for McDonald, there's a shot! And getting a piece of that with the blocker was Burke, and he sends it up over the glass and out of play. With 7:41 gone here in the second period. Face off to the left of goaltender Andrew Burke. Right off of the draw, Burke has to steer that aside. And then it's sent down the ice. Coming out to play it is Fleming. And the puck gets all the way to McKenzie. McKenzie for Baldwin. Baldwin nearly misplaced that. Christmas able to get it and play it out to center. Coleman will back it up. And now dumped into the rush zone, but it was an icing with 8:12 going here in period number two. Mustangs. Ritzy dumps the puck in, goes chasing after it, also getting in there. That was Wilkins, and then Asbridge with the shot from the point. Eight and a half minutes exactly gone here in the second period. Edwards loses the draw to Berkovici, but the puck ends up actually going to Soller, so it worked out for the run. Now it's Soller. Gives to LaFrenz. LaFrenz tried to play it back to Soller, but it came dangerously to the side of the net. Edwards able to clear it away from him. Now here's Allen coming in. He lost his footing, and the puck rolls harmlessly into Fleming, who covers up and hangs on for a faceoff. 11:07 left to go here in the second. Still 2-1 in favor of the Rush, as it has been since the 11:32 mark of period number one. Although we saw that in the earlier game, it was 2-1 for the Weeks over Valley for more than two periods before the Weeks got a couple of third period goals and ended up making it 5-1 the final. There's a shot from the point, save made there by Fleming. Now battling behind the net, coming out with the puck, and it rolls to the line, and helping to get it out to center there was Cook. Sent back in. Long lead pass, Sampson gets a piece of that to deflect it away. And Soller has to go back and pick up. He's got Zwicker hot on his heels. Soller brings it behind the net. McKenzie, he nearly coughs it up. Matthews now trying to clear. Zwicker knocks that down. And Leyenwand will wrap it around the boards to the far side. Getting to it is Campbell. Through the line and out. Connors picks up in neutral ice. He'll play it ahead. Soller back on it. He plays it back up to center again. Connors goes to dump it back in. It goes off a body. Leyenwand is there. He's trying to get around his man. Puck goes behind the net. Comes around to the near side. Soller looks to poke it ahead to Matthews. Not able to do so as Leyenwand is right in there. Now here's Zwicker. His shot blocked by Sampson. And the puck ends up out of neutral ice. Lead pass. Trying to set up Westlake. That doesn't quite work. Now here's Campbell. Campbell has a little bit of trouble controlling the puck, but is able to keep it and then gets it to Clark. Clark plays it deep, but the Mustangs pick up there. And out they come. Here's Leyenwand. Leyenwand comes in, takes a shot. That goes into the glass. Comes all the way around the boards and out to center. McNeil. Played it back in, delayed offside. That gives the friends a little bit of time. Now Clark, quick one-touch pass. Nice little move there. There's a shot by O'Neill, save made. And Fleming able to cover up and hang on for a faceoff with 8:39 left to go here in period two. What a nice little move by Logan O'Neill to set up that shot. Gets waved out of the faceoff circle because the Rush were a little confused as to who they wanted. Baldwin shot right into the shin pads of Westlake, that's Potty rather, 20, not 10. Potty now chases it down, gets it to McNeil. McNeil works it back to the point, but not able to hold it. Was Wilkin, and he'll send it back in. Delayed offside is going to give a little bit of time for McKenzie behind his own net now, waiting for things to get organized. Makes the pass. Second pass on the way out. A little bit behind the intended target of Seymour, but now Seymour chases it down, gets it to Marr over across for O'Neill. And O'Neill couldn't get a shot away. as he double clutched there. Now here's Marr with the puck. He'll play it back to the line for McKenzie. McKenzie tees it up. That hits the body in front. Seymour with the shot. And able to cover up is Cooper Fleming. And then we get some pushing and shoving after the whistle. 7:43 left to go here in period number two. Faceoff will be to the left of Fleming. Gets to the line. Caller with a shot. That was blocked. And then McIntyre with the shot. Pattingale now having a little trouble controlling it, but he's able to get it to Christmas. Christmas trying to get a shot. He couldn't. Puck flips up high and it ends up hitting the netting just over the glass here at the Pictou County Wellness Center with 7:20 left to go. Christmas in to keep the draw, wins it cleanly back to Pattingale. Pattingale's shot comes off the end boards. Picking it up is Crane. Crane trying to tie up, waiting for help. The Mustangs force the turnover. And out to center it comes, and picked up there by Soller. Soller, he'll dump it right back into the Mustang end. Fleming out of the net to settle it down. And then a lead pass from Harlow. Goes all the way down the ice. Pattingale gets to it before it reaches the goal line, so no icing. With it now is McKenzie, or McIntyre, excuse me. McIntyre working his way down the ice. Had the puck get a little bit too far in front of him. That allows Hopkins to get it. And a pass now for Ritchie. Here comes Ritchie. He'll dump it in. Going back to pick up Soller. Both he and one of the Mustangs players end up going right by the puck. And now Pattingale, his pass goes off the skate. And Soller has to go back and pick up. Being watched by Berkovici, so Soller plays it back towards Crane at the near wall. Crane ends up flipping it over the glass and out of play. 6:04 left here in the second period. Plenty of action, but nothing. Soller apparently, apparently went off of a Mustang player as it was flipped up, and so the faceoff came outside the zone. Plenty of action, but no goals, no penalties yet here in the second period. Down the length of the ice. Some nice long segments of play as well as Dowden Haynes goes back and gets it. We've had a couple of lengthy stretches without a whistle, which always makes the game a lot more entertaining, certainly. The friends behind the net wraps it around. Dowden Haynes gets to it, sends it back down low. The friends takes a bump there from Cook. Puck played over. Dowden Haynes not able to keep it in. Here comes Edwards. Edwards, he's got Allen with him. Edwards takes a backhand shot. The save gets made. And Fleming holds on for a face-off with 5:09 left to go. Shots on goal in the first period, by the way, were 11-11 in this piece, in this period. Rush with a 10-5 shot advantage. Now it's 11-5 off of that shot taken by Matthews. And a big pass save off of it. Now a chance trying to get a pass through for Zwicker. That was broken up and Clark will come the other way. This pass for Matthews. Here comes Matthews with a shot. Save made. Clark gets the puck, plays it back up the wall. It comes all the way to McKenzie at the line. He plays it across for his defense partner, Baldwin. That shot gets steered aside and now the puck back with Baldwin again. As he backs up into his own zone, played ahead. Race to get to the puck. Asbridge will get there just in front of his man. As as Seymour was caught on his heels. Now as Richter fires it down into the rough zone. Back to get it, Pattingale. Pattingale puts that one high in the air. It comes down, rolls all the way into the goaltender Asbury, or Fleming. Fleming will cover up with 4:07 left to go. He'll take the ball. Mar wins it to Seymour. He plays it back to Soller. Seymour now with the shot. Save made. And the Mustangs clear it out. Soller gets tripped up as he was trying to walk free. Now it's out to center. Jump back in again. Soller with it. He gives to Pattingale. Pattingale out to center. McNeil tries to glove it down, but it goes off of his glove, and the next player to touch it was Arlo, and so that's going to be a hand pass. And the faceoff will come just outside the Mustang blue line. 3:34 to go here in the third period. Christmas and Coleman take the faceoff. Coleman wins it back to Galvin Haynes. He tried to play it ahead for Joseph, but that gets broken up. Now there's a shot and another save made by Fleming. And he'll hang on to the faceoff, 3:25. Left in the second. Back to Campbell. Campbell with the shot. Fleming takes a stab at it with his glove. It goes off the glove and comes to the near wall. Now Coleman able to get it ahead out to center. But quickly turned the other way by LaFrenz. Now it's brought down again by LaFrenz. They'll play it back to Campbell. Campbell gets it ahead. McIntyre. Now in the corner, Christmas. Can come out of the corner with it. He does. Gets the shot away. And that's steered aside by Fleming. McIntyre plays it towards the front of the net. That's deflected. It goes way up into the air and ends up going over the glass and out of play. 2:45 left here in the period. Face-off will be the near side as we're looking at it, to the right of goaltender Cooper Fleming. Allen gets the puck. Takes it into the corner. Asbridge knocks it away from him, plays it around to the far side. Cook there waiting for it. He has it knocked off his stick and it goes back behind the net. Wilkin plays it ahead and out come the Mustangs as McCarty played it across to Berkovici and then into Cook. Edwards gets it up to Allen as the rush come back the other way. Allen, his pass goes just past Edwards, and the Mustangs will clear the zone. Baldwin plays it back to McKenzie. He gets it up for Edwards. Edwards gets it around Wilkin, but Wilkin goes back and picks up the puck and a nice little move to get away from one forechecker, but not able to get away from Allen. Hutchins plays it down low. Wilkin can't get past Edwards. He plays it back to the line for Soller. Soller down into the corner. Asbridge plays it back up. Soller is there. Now it's Allen. He tries to center it for, or tries to play, set it up for Hutchins, or for Edwards. He gets broken up. 80 seconds left to go in the period. Allen with a dangerous hit right into the back of Cook, and they're going to call that boarding. They could easily have called that a check from behind. So the first penalty of this period comes at 18:45. The first penalty of the game against the Sydney Mitsubishi Rush comes at 18:45 of the second period. Zalek goes off for Bourdon. And the South Shore Mustangs get their first power play of the game. For the Mustangs, they've scored just 3 power play goals all season. As that has been a bit of an area where they need a little bit of work. The penalties, if they don't score in this next 40 seconds, will carry over into the third period. Play back to the line. Now to Harlow near side. Harlow returns it to Hopkins. Hopkins with the shot. No, it goes off of the post and somehow stays out. Oh, so close for the Mustangs, but that puck somehow stays out. Now here's Harlow with the puck. Back to Hopkins again. 13 seconds left. Back to Harlow. To Hopkins. Hopkins fakes the shot, then plays it far side. Chance for McNeil and a couple of whacks at it. And finally, Burke able to cover up and hang on. 5.1 seconds left in the period, but so close to tying up this game were the South Shore Mustangs off that shot by Hopkins. But it stays 2-1. Westlake now to take the draw against Marr. Westlake tries to push it forward towards the net. It goes past the net. And that will do it for period number 2. Shots on goal in the period finish 16-7 for the Rush. The 2 period total 27-18 for the Rush. And as mentioned, the Mustangs will carry 45 seconds of power play time into period number 3. It was 2-1 rush after 1, it's 2-1 rush after 2. We'll take a break, come back into break 4 of the third period in just a few minutes. You are watching Nova Scotia Under 18 Major Hockey League Showcase action on Petter Pictou Sports 3-3-6-9. Welcome back as we get ready for the start of the third period here. The Rush leading the Mustangs 2-1. This game playing out so far very similar to the last game that we had, where it was 2-1 after one. It was still 2-1 after two. In that game, the Weeks, who carried the 2-1 lead into the third period, ended up scoring three times in the third to end up with a 5-1 victory. Is it going to be more of the same in this one? Or are we going to see a comeback by the Mustangs? Mustangs with 45 seconds of power play time to start the third period. That certainly could have a positive impact for them on their comeback efforts. We've seen some wild, wild finishes to games here at the Wellness Center this weekend. One involving Steel Subaru and the Valley Wildcats. It was 4-0 for Steel Subaru at one point. Valley fought back, eventually we're trailing 7-6 in the final minute, and with 12.1 seconds left, it looked like they had scored the game tying goal. It ended up getting waved off due to the puck being kicked in, and then 10 seconds later, with 3 seconds left, the Dartmouth Steel Subaru were able to score an empty net goal and secure what became an 8-6 victory. We had another game involving this same Sydney Mitsubishi Rush leading 3-0 going into the final 5 minutes. The Mats pulled their goalie and scored with 4:17 to go, making it 3-1. Wilkin works his way ahead, his pass to Potty. Potty has it rolled away from him. Potty and Pattingale going to the end boards. Now there's a shot for Wilkin. That goes just wide. Pattingale not able to clear as Wilkin keeps it in. He gets it to Mitchie for the door in front of the net. They score! It goes off the stick of Zoller, thrown towards the net by Berkovici. And the game-tying goal does indeed happen on the power play, just 26 seconds into the third period. And I think it's safe to say we're in for a wild finish tie this game up. Berkovici throws it towards the net. It goes off the stick of Soller and somehow hops behind his goaltender. Brock McNeil gets the assist, so it's Matthew Berkovici on the power play, his fourth goal, seventh point of the season, assisted by McNeil at 26 seconds, tie up this game. Draw one back to LaFrenz. LaFrenz with a shot. And there's a quick save by Fleming. Fanning on his shot was Campbell. Now the puck comes back to Campbell. He'll play it down the boards. Coming over to pick up the loose puck is Westlake. Westlake takes a bump. Puck played up the wall. And now Leon Wand able to get it ahead. Here comes McCarty. McCarty with a shot. And the save made. Puck cleared over to the far side. Now back around to the near side. And he's picked up right ahead to O'Neill and out to center. They back down the wall. O'Neill picks it up again. This time he'll carry it through himself. Gets knocked off the puck just inside the blue line, and Westlake will dump it down. LaFrenz. 2 minutes go. LaFrenz ends up over skating the puck. Recovers, gets it back, plays it ahead for Seymour. Seymour, his pass to McIntyre. McIntyre working his way down into the corner, has the puck taken from him by Dowden Haynes, wrapped around the boards to Ritzy. Ritzy gets it out to center. Soller is there, he plays it up for Crane. Crane will fire it in, and it's picked up again by Dowden Haynes. He plays it up the wall and out as Patton Gale not able to hold. Now Soller with it. He fires it back in, out of the net to settle it down is Fleming for Connors. It comes to McIntyre, he fires a shot just wide. Now Patton Gale with it. He'll send it back down the boards to Christmas. Christmas trying to center it, but Joseph able to tie up his man enough. Now a shot from Soller that gets blocked. Goes up over the glass and out of play. And we'll get a stoppage with 2:49 gone here in the third period. Clark taking the face off. It's won by McNeil of the Mustangs, however. Comes to the line, not out. The Stanchion helping out the Sydney Mitsubishi rush there. Potty deflects the puck down the ice. That'll be called an icing against the Mustangs. And so we'll move all the way back down into the South Shore end. Just over 3 minutes gone in the third period of what is now a tie hockey game. Matthew Berkovici scoring on the power play, fired it from the corner towards the net, had it deflect off the stick of Van Soller, the rush defenseman, and go over the shoulder of Andrew Burke. Here's Baldwin now. He sends it into the far corner. Asbridge gets to it first. He'll play it up the wall to McDonald. McDonald gets it to the line, not out. McKenzie knocks it down. Second effort does clear the puck out of the zone for the Mustangs. McDonald trying to get to it in time, but he does not, so it's going to be an icing. There's 16:22 left to go. Wins it back to McKenzie. McKenzie down to Allen. Allen trying to work away from the check. Gets it back to McKenzie again. Now to the near side, Baldwin. Baldwin's shot. Gets through, gets deflected, goes up the glass. McKenzie trying to pinch in, but McDonald will get it out past him. Baldwin will pick up. Baldwin plays it ahead. Allen brings it back in across the line. Allen gets to Edwards with the shot. Hutchings with the shot. save made by Fleming. Just under 16 minutes left to go here in the third. Christmas wins it back to the line. Nice little move by Campbell to adjust the shooting lane. There's a chance! And Fleming able to get back off of that second chance opportunity for Crane. Now Christmas turns, tries to fire. Puck rolls off his stick. Berkovici coming out. Here comes Berkovici. He's got Cook with him. Berkovici. But a big play by LaFrance to knock the puck off of his stick. Now in behind the net. Zwicker. Zwicker with it. Back to the line for Hopkins. He plays it back down to Zwicker. That's broken up by Christmas. And Christmas comes out. Here's McIntyre. And we're going to get a offside call against the rush, it appears. No, we're going to get a penalty. Okay, we're going to get a pair of penalties. It's Crane and Berkovici well behind the play. So, coincidental penalty. As coaching staff of the Mustangs look for an explanation. But it boils down to coincidental penalties at 4:45. Nothing called against Crane and Berkovici. And so we'll stay 5-on-5. Those two big things over. There's Lane One. His pass, not able to connect. Lane One gets back on the puck. He fires it towards the net, speared aside by Burke. Marr with it now. Gets it up to O'Neill. O'Neill for Seymour. Seymour coming in. Seymour across! And Pattingale just couldn't quite get his stick on it. And then after the whistle, we get some pushing and shoving down in the corner. Officials able to get them separated, though. And it looks like the rush will get a power play out of this now. As Lane won. Gets two for boarding. So at 5:21, Melchor is shorthanded for the second time in this game. Landwand off for the board. Shot goes into the glass, comes up the wall to Christmas. Down into the corner, Edwards. Back to Baldwin. Baldwin gives it back to Edwards. Edwards throws it across, looking to go back door to Pattingale. But getting a piece of that puck was quicker. And it's fired down the length of the ice. And it'll be picked up there by Baldwin. Baldwin starting to work his way ahead. Makes the pass over to Allen. Allen trying to work through Zwicker. That doesn't work. And the rush have to go all the way back. 1:20 left in the power play. Here's Baldwin working it forward again. Baldwin, his pass ahead for McIntyre. McIntyre, Baldwin can't take that pass cleanly. It comes across the near side, and the Mustangs able to get it back out. Christmas loses control, coming out to play the puck. There is Burke. He'll wrap it around before the side ball. Allen there to pick it up. All of a sudden, this sound system gets way louder. As the Mustangs, or the Rush rather, ice the puck. 43 seconds left in the power play. 13:22 left in what is a tie hockey game. After the Mustangs tied it up on the power play. Now Seymour gets tripped up, looks for a call, not going to get one. Here comes Wilkin with a shot, and the save made by Burke. stepped on the blade of the stick and ended up going down of his own volition was, I think, the rationale for the non-call there. Although I have seen situations like that get called either way. Sometimes it's a penalty, sometimes it's not. Here's Marr with the puck. Marr working his way ahead. Marr has the puck roll off his stick as he comes into the offensive zone. We're going to play it back to Soller. There's a shot as we're back to 5-on-5. Marr gets it down into the corner for O'Neill. O'Neill back to Soller. Soller sends it towards the net. That's blocked. And coming out with it is Wilkin. Wilkin skates through a couple of checks. Now gets down into the corner with it. Puck is turned over to Baldwin, however, and now Baldwin will work his way forward. His pass across for Seymour. As the English language is speaking for a minute. Here comes McDonald the other way. McDonald going back to, what a play by the defenseman on the back check. That was, looking to see who it was Baldwin. What a play by Drew Baldwin. That guy right there makes an incredible play and gets some taps from his teammates as he gets back to the men. Drew Baldwin with a possible game-saving play. Hopkins. He gets run over, but he was able to make the play before he did so. Now the puck out to center. Picked up by LaFrenz. LaFrenz plays in ahead as the physicality of this game. Checks being delivered all over the place. Puck comes to LaFrenz at the line. He was not able to hold it in. So it'll be an offside with 11:25 left to go. Cook plays it back, now ahead for Zwicker. Zwicker couldn't maintain control, now it's dumped in by Berkovici. Around to the far side, Cook going after it, gets there just ahead of LaFrenz. Plays it to Zwicker, he sends it back to the line, shot from the point goes wide. Berkovici back with it again. He loses it as Christmas able to make the steal. Now Christmas off the wall, held in at the line there by Dowden Haynes. Berkovici takes a stab at it. He couldn't get it with his hand. And the rush get it out to center, but coming right back in again. There's Wicker with a shot. Save made. And covering up and hanging on is Andrew Burke. 10:39 left to go. Third period. We want to take this opportunity here at Petter Pictou Sports and 360 Live to thank the week's major organization for inviting us to be part of this Nova Scotia Under 18 Major Hockey League Showcase event. We really appreciate the chance to be here and to be able to call all these games throughout this weekend. As we still have half a period and maybe even a little bit more than that left to go as we're tied up here. Wilkin gets it to Westlake. He gets it ahead to McCarty. Here comes McCarty. McCarty with a shot. And the save made by the glove of Burke and no chance for a rebound there. And a reminder again that each and every week's home game that is played here on this device is available through Petter Pictou Sports through 360 Live over the course of the season, and that will carry over into the playoffs as well. Marr tried to play it down the boards, that gets knocked down. Potty gets it ahead to McDonald. McDonald tried to make a pass back to Potty, but he overskated, and here comes O'Neill. O'Neill gets taken to the boards by Hopkins. O'Neill able to get back on the puck, however. Now he overskates it. Hopkins able to tie up O'Neill. But O'Neill gets it back again. Now in front for Marr. And his shot is blocked. Out come the Mustangs the other way. Pass rolls off the toe of the stick of McDonald, so he couldn't get much on that. And now Soller leads the rush back the other way. Great back and forth action. Here comes Seymour. What a save. Rebound. Marr couldn't get a stick on it. Now Soller with a shot. And I think that was Hopkins who made that block. Soller gets it. Over to Marr. And we get a whistle as the net is off its moorings. What great chances for the Sydney Mitsubishi Rush. But every single player on the Mustangs throwing their bodies wherever they have to keep that puck out of the net. Not only did Cooper Fleming make some saves, but a couple other members of the Mustangs did as well. Now Dowden Haynes gets it ahead to Joseph. He's able to play it out to center. Joseph dumps it deep into the rush zone. Baldwin behind the net, changes direction, gets it up. And out comes Clark. His pass across. Big hit delivered there by Connors. Clark gets on the puck, centers it. Joseph clears it as far as the line, held in by Baldwin. Now behind the net, Clark wraps it around the boards. It comes to McKenzie. McKenzie back to Clark. Clark goes far side for Baldwin. Baldwin down below the goal line. Connors has lost a glove. He's able to pick it back up as the puck comes over to the near side. McKenzie works it down. Sampson plays it back to McKenzie. McKenzie tees it up. That one goes wide. Doesn't miss by a whole bunch. Now Baldwin down into the corner. Going after it was Matthews. Comes back to Baldwin again. Baldwin makes a move to get around one person. Now down into the corner. Throws it to the front. And it comes all the way to the near side wall. Joseph gets it out to center. Dumps it the rest of the way down. Clark there to pick up. He'll wrap it around the boards to Baldwin. Baldwin sends it back to McKenzie. Baldwin again. Now he'll start to rush up. He'll play it ahead. Pass for Christmas. Christmas having trouble maintaining it. And now it comes back to McIntyre at his own blue line. McIntyre plays it ahead. That goes down the ice. And the Mustangs pick up, so they'll start to work their way back. Here's Cook. Cook gets taken down. Christmas aims up getting the puck, trying to work his way around Wilkin. Christmas down into the corner. McIntyre with it now. He'll work his way all the way back to the line. Comes to the near side for Crane. Crane's shot goes wide. Comes around the boards. And Campbell sends it back down into the corner. Now here's Zwicker with it. He uses the boards to try and get it to Cook, but it takes a bounce off the stanchion. That works in the favor of the rush. Crane tries to send it towards the net and go after it, but the Mustangs are there. Now here's Cook with it. Cook coming in, has it poked off his stick. McIntyre's pass into the body of Crane. He couldn't find it, then Christmas overskates it. Berkovici, he'll take it all the way back to his own line. Now come back up the other way. Here comes Berkovici, heading towards the net. Throws it towards the front of the net. And Christmas is there to clear it away from danger. 6:18 to go here in the third period. McCarty overskated that pass, able to get it back now. They'll play it down into the zone. Here's LaFrenz with it. He'll play it ahead for Hutchins. Hutchins able to get it deep into the Mustang zone. Back to pick up. Harlow, he wraps it around. Edwards there. Edwards has Hutchins with him in the corner as the two rush players able to work it away from Hopkins and Wesley. Back into the corner again. They continue to battle. Finally it comes out. But a big hustle by Allen to keep that puck onside. Now it comes to Edwards with a shot. Kick save, rebound! And another save. Puck still loose. And McCarty able to work it free, and out he comes to center. Puck knocked away from McCarty. Hutchings playing it ahead. Here's Edwards now. Edwards down to the corner. Avoids the hit from Connors as he turns. Allen right in there as well. Edwards takes it behind the net, comes towards the near corner. He's tied up by Harlow. Harlow takes a bump from Allen as Allen comes over to get the puck. Now Sala with the shot, and they score! Sala through the traffic, and I don't think Cooper Fleming saw a thing. But the Rush retakes the lead, it's 3-2. So Dan Soller, his second goal, fifth point of the season. And that gives his team back the lead. Here's Marlin, the shot that's blocked. How does Frazier, the goaltender, get an assist on that? That's got to be a mistake. Goal coming at 16 or 15:08, excuse me. It's announced as being Soller's goal. Second goal, fifth point. Assisted by Blake Edwards and the goaltender, Lucas Frazier, who's not even playing. And now a penalty to Wilkin with 4:07 left for Griffiths. There's Edwards, shot, and rebound, and Christmas, no, it gets waved off, as the whistle is blown, and then the monster is gone. So for Reese Allen, his second goal, sixth point of the season, second point of this game. Scored on the power play, we'll get the assists for you in a moment. Soller plays it ahead to O'Neill. O'Neill to Marr. Marr across, they score again! This time it's Seymour, and three goals. And this will be Seymour's second of the day. And what was a tie game just a couple of minutes ago all of a sudden there's now a 5-2 score in favor of the Rush. Baldwin dumps it in. And it's covered up by Fleming, and he'll hang on with 3:06 left. Still haven't gotten the announcement of the fourth goal yet. So we can tell you for sure that fifth goal was definitely Seymour from Marr and O'Neill, as that passing play was pretty easy to watch and very well executed. All coming in on that rush. Now Baldwin plays it over to McKenzie. 245. So the fourth goal was Reese Allen, assisted to and the fifth goal, as we knew, Seymour from Marr and O'Neill at 16:48. So again, three goals in the span of a minute 40 turned what was a 2-2 tie into a 5-2 lead for the Rush. Gamble sending it down low as the Rush now lead by three, and they have the Mustangs hemmed in their own zone. Here's another chance for Allen. He scores again! And that's certainly going to be the icing on the cake for the Rush, making it 6-2. Reese Allen getting his second goal. Four goals coming in a span of 2 minutes 56 seconds. So, yes, 2 minutes 56 seconds. Reese Allen gets his second of the game and his third of the season. As we're down to the final 90 seconds. Edwards and Hutchins with the assists on that one. So Allen and Edwards, a big part of that 3-minute spell, or just under 3-minute spell, as between them, they get 6 points. Edwards with 3 assists. Allen with 2 wins and an assist. We're now into the final minute of what, up until the 15:08 mark, looked like was going to be an exciting finish right to the last second. But now, this final minute, somewhat anticlimactic, as 4 goals in 2:56. Will give the Rush the victory. Pattingill, 28 seconds left. Plays it to Christmas. Christmas lets it go through to McIntyre, or lets it go through the park. McIntyre will dump it down. Asbridge back to get it. As Clark lost an edge and went into the boards awkwardly. Here's Soller now. His shot goes wide. 6 seconds left. And that is going to do it. The Rush come down to Pictou County and earn a split. They drop a heartbreaker against the Halifax McDonalds, but they don't let that faze them as they come back and earn a great victory over the South Shore Mustangs. That's going to do it for the 2020 Nova Scotia Under-18 Major Hockey League Showcase Weekend. Our next broadcast on Petter Pictou Sports will be next weekend. Just taking a quick look to reconfirm the schedule here. Next weekend, our first broadcast, we'll have three games on the 28th next Saturday at 2, 5, and 7. We'll start with the Fire at the Selects. Until then, this is Michael Petter saying, may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Final score one last time. The Rush beat the Mustangs 6-2. Thanks for watching. Have a great night and enjoy the rest of your weekend.